Hey friends, it's me, the Ebony Otaku, the well-rounded nerd. It's been a minute. No excuses, just, you know, life. The weather changed and I'm a homeowner, so it's that time of year where I looked for all of those projects to do on the weekends that would make my home more enjoyable during the spring, summer, and early fall. So I got all of those things done and I'm super happy, which means I can now take my free time again and make more YouTube videos. So today's video, as you saw in the title, is continuing our series on Asian cooking. We started out with pantry items, and now we moved on to cooking vessels. Last time we looked at a rather large category, bowls, things you cook in, and I wanted to take that a step further today. Once in a while, as I move around, you might see extra light behind me. I'm not doing anything illegal. Homegirl is attempting to grow vegetables from seedlings for the first time. What am I growing? I've got my little herb garden with like basil, cilantro, and chives, stuff like that in it. But then I'm also doing peppers, cucumbers, lettuce, and tomatoes. And I also have a perilla plant growing, which I'm super excited about because that's used in a lot of Korean cooking. Instead of using like lettuce or something to wrap, you can use perilla leaves, and they're good for making pancakes with and stuff like that. So if that turns out to be semi-successful, you'll see a video about it, but I still have a little while until my friends back there go outside. So every time I move, that's just the light making sure they don't die. So today I want to talk about things that steam, which also is a rather large category. In your kitchen, you want to make sure that you don't use a lot of what Halton Brown calls unitaskers, you know, cooking tools or vessels that can only be used for one thing. Now, granted, there's always going to be some kind of unitasker out there that's just what it does. Like a whisk, it whisks stuff. That's its job, you know, but if you're going to invest in something like, oh, I don't know, the bread maker, you know, you want to use it for more than just one function, because for most of us, we don't make bread every day. But that thing also does pizza dough. You can make jams in it. It is great for warming certain types of pastries and breads. So it has multiple functions. And when you go into buying more gadgets for your kitchen, you want to understand, how am I going to use these things in my day-to-day? And if you're not going to make use of it, then you might not want to add it to your collection. But if there is a culinary use for it in your kitchen, well then, by all means, go find the thing. We're going to start with the most obvious tool. Da-da-da-da! The rice cooker. Now this is an itty bitty one, and this is the first rice cooker I ever had. The bowl comes out. Look at this little bowl, is it not the cutest? And you know, it's literally enough for one person. So when I first got this rice cooker, I ordered it on Amazon. It wasn't more than $15. I swear it was like 10. It was not expensive. What brand is it? No, I'm not going to tell you, because then it's going to look like it's sponsored, and it's not sponsored. But I bought this because at the time, at least in my household, I was the only person who ate rice in any significant quantity. Not with every single meal, but you know, if I did something like wanted to make gimbap, or maybe a couple of little rice balls, or just, you know, some rice and throw some oyster sauce on it and call it a snack, you know, rice and egg bowl for breakfast. You know, it was handier to have a rice cooker. And recently I also started using this as a individual soup warmer as well. So if I just wanted a bowl of soup for myself and I didn't want to go through all the trouble of using the microwave and, you know, having to cover it and things not splatter, I would just use this, because then there's no chance my microwave is going to get dirty, and it's just one thing to clean as well. So I initially got this because I was the only one around who ate rice in a significant quantity, but I quickly learned, oh, I can do way more than cook rice in this thing. Soup being one of my favorites. If I'm doing like an individual portion of something like spaghetti, I'll warm my sauce up in this little guy. So you can think outside of the box ways that you can use these cooking tools, gadgets, whatever you want to call them, besides the purpose that is written on the box. But then, of course, I had to take it a step further. This past December was my birthday, and my mom was like, "What do you want for your birthday?" And I was like, "I want a big rice cooker." And the reason being is one, like I said before, I do like to make stuff like rice balls. Well, it's not as easy to make them just, half a cup of rice at a time. It's better to have a big quantity so you can make a bunch and, have them for a couple of days. And then also, rice cookers have multiple functions. You can steam vegetables in them. I have steamed vegetables and seafood in my new one. So for my birthday last year, here it comes. Oh, the cord's tangled around my garbage can. All right, this is what I got for my birthday. This is a Narita, which is the same brand as my little hot plate that I use for hot pots. I didn't realize that I was very brandy with my Asian cooking gadgets, but it turns out I like this Narita brand. A lot of stuff that I use turned out to be this brand. It just happened. I don't know how it happened. It just did. But I'm gonna open this guy up. Got one big handle. This is what I love about a lot of these appliances from Asia. They are so easy to use. Notice the one button. You go ploop, it cooks, and then it turns off and keeps it warm. That's the whole process of using this rice cooker, and I love it. Now, you can get real fancy and get you like a pressure cooker, rice cooker, Zojirushi sings at you and, does your dishes. Those exist. It's an option. I didn't go with that option. One, because my mom was buying me a gift and I'm not going to ask her for a $300 rice cooker. And two, I like the simplicity because if you notice on my little rice cooker, it also only had one button. So you literally set it and forget it, and you almost can't ruin the food unless you're trying to. But like I said, let me go ahead and open this guy up. It just has one button. Ooh, and in the top you have a steamer basket. This sits on top of the actual colander. Well, that's not a colander. What is that called? The pot that holds the rice. So I got this guy, and I've got a little plastic liner in there because I've used it to like steam corn and broccoli and stuff. So I didn't want that, going down into, little bits getting down into my big pot in here. But then you've got the giant pot that you actually use for cooking your rice or whatever. I've mostly just used this portion for rice at this point, but if you look in here, there's little measurements. See that? So it's basically, not to be mean, it's idiot proof. And that's what I love about it. You don't really have to know any kind of measurements to use this. What you do is you look and see what measurement of rice and water you want to use. Each rice cooker comes with its own cup. And these two rice cookers that I have, they each have their own cup. So when recipes and these things call for a cup of rice, it's not like a measuring cup, it's the cup that comes with the rice cooker. Don't ever lose it. You'll be real mad if you do. But there's on one side, it asks you, it says, "Hey, here's how many cups you need." And then it's like, "Well, here's how much water you need for that amount of cups." So you put your rice in, give it a wash, get all the extra starch out. And then you fill up to the line of water that you need. And it works for all types of rice. I've cooked white rice in here, sticky rice, brown rice, basmati rice, jasmine rice. I've cooked a lot of rices in here, and they've all come out great. It's easy. I have put seafood in this little steamer basket because you'll put a little bit of water in, well, more than a little bit. Put the water in here, stick your steamer basket on top, and then you close it, turn it on, set it, forget it. It's gonna stay moist and warm because it's in a container that's gonna continue to circulate that hot steam. So you're not going to burn it and you're not gonna dry it out. So if you've got other things to prepare, it's great. And again, super easy cleanup. That's another thing I like about it. I've also done it where I've got the rice in the bottom and maybe I have my meat dish steaming in the top. I'll put maybe my tilapia or my salmon up here with some broccoli. Not even always an Asian dish, just one place to do all the cooking. It kind of reminds me of that guy. Whoa, that guy, the air fryer. The air fryer is like that as well. You can put raw ingredients in there, and with minimal effort and mess, whoo, you've got a cooked meal, and it's wonderful. So, I do recommend if there's more than one person in your house that likes rice, get one. And if they're, you're looking for a healthier way to prepare certain things through steaming versus frying or anything like that, if you don't have an air fryer, this is a great option. I mean, you can make mashed potatoes in this thing. Like, I have figured out all kinds of stuff, and I can't wait to get into my recipe videos once I am able to eat freely again. Now, this next one is kind of a twofer. When I started getting things that steam, I first got my little bitty pink, cute little rice cooker that I love. As you, homegirl loves pink, what can I say? But then I was like, when you're doing dumplings or maybe a steamed bun, seafood, veggies, stuff like that. I was like, well, I want a steamer basket. And this was pre-big rice cooker. So I got a bamboo steamer. And mine is two layers, and you can find this in any Asian grocery store. They're not expensive. I think I paid like $9 for this one. It wasn't expensive at all. Oh, and the big Narita rice cooker for that, I want to say that guy was like $39.99 or $49.99. And it's one of those appliances that never breaks. So you got it for a long, long time. They're very well made. Anywho, but with this guy, I use him a lot for specifically dumplings and steamed buns. I don't put a lot of like fresh food ingredients in here, like seafood, beef, chicken, anything like that, only because it is bamboo and I like preserving that bamboo flavor. You start putting a lot of other ingredients in there, and it's wood. It's gonna soak up what you put in there. So I'm very careful about what I put in there. You don't have to be. You do what you want. But you can steam by placing this over a pot of water. What I do with my steamer basket is I use this guy. My wok, and we'll talk about woks later. That's a whole other video. But with my wok down here, you'll see two chopsticks. Now, I don't cook with metal chopsticks in the wok. This thing came with a wooden spatula and a wooden lid and wooden chopsticks for cooking. That's because you don't want to scratch this up. This is cast iron, and you don't want to make rusty grooves in it. But for steaming, I use the metal chopsticks down there because I don't, again, my wooden chopsticks, I've had the same pair for a while, and I don't want to warp them over time, sticking them in hot water over and over. So I just use the metal ones. But I'll set those in there. So, and notice it gives you what, like an inch above the bottom of the pan. And then once the steam starts coming in the bottom of the wok, you set this on top, and you've got the best steamer setup you could possibly have. One of the reasons I love doing it in the wok is the wok comes up to temperature very fast. If you notice, compared to most pans we use in the West, the sides are very thin. And because of that, it heats very quickly and woks heat very evenly. So if you're trying to go fast what you're doing, this is the way to go. And again, it's another one of those set it and forget it. It's not as much because the steam is going up into the atmosphere with the wok. So you might have to come back and put a little bit of extra water back in the bottom. You don't have to worry about that so much with the enclosed rice cookers if you're using those for steaming, because it's all trapped. But it's not trapped in the wok. So keep an eye on it so you don't scorch the bottom of your pan. But super easy to steam. And in here, there's several ways you can line it. I've got some parchment paper in here at the moment that's cut for the size of my steamer, but they also make silicone pads that can go in here. Traditionally, you can lay down like cabbage leaves or lettuce leaves, something like that, to protect your food. If you use cabbage, what's great is cabbage is super hard and crunchy. So if you want cabbage as your side dish, you just put your dumplings and stuff on top of the cabbage, and it steams with it. But you have your side dish and your main dish done at the same time. But I love this. And it's also one of those that, like I said, it assumes aromatics. So say you have a recipe that calls for something like ginger, or you're making like special glutinous rice cakes, and you use like pine needles to set your rice cakes on to steam. Over time, this will gather those flavors, which again is why I'm particular about what I put in here, because I'm not trying to buy one of these every 6 months. Because I do use it. This probably gets used twice a month, maybe, because I have so many options now, and I just personally like collecting cooking stuff. It's fun for me. But there's one more I want to look at. Last steaming tool I want to look at is, well, an actual steamer. Yes, I do have an actual stovetop steamer. And some places call this a double boiler. Maybe in Europe you might hear it called a bain-marie. All the same thing. You got hot water in the bottom and something on top where the hot water is dissipating to do the process of cooking. I love this guy. So here's the big pot. This is the bottom. So this is where the water goes. And then you have this steamer tray that sits on top. Works much like it would with the rice cooker. This one, because it's stainless steel, I typically don't line it with anything because stainless steel is super easy to clean. But uses I've had for this one, other than the traditional Asian dishes, I did a whole seafood boil for myself in this one pot. So in the bottom, I did my broth base for my vegetables. Like I had corn and potatoes and then, you know, some shrimps, stuff like that. That went in the pot and cooked. And when it got good and steamy, I took this portion and put like my lobster tails and my crab claws. I swear I had something else. What was it? Scallops. I had scallops. I put the scallops in there and then let that steam on top for 10 minutes and boom, homegirl had the best meal ever. Might do that next week now that I'm talking about it out loud. But it was super delicious and easy. And also it gives you a whole other pot in your kitchen because you don't have to use it as a steamer. This is a whole pot and it's a good deep pot too. So if you're doing like a stew, but you're not wanting to make, you know, Cuisinart sized level of stew, this is the guy. Or if I'm trying to make a reasonable amount of homemade broth, I can use this guy to do it and then get an amount that will actually fit in my freezer versus that big thing, which I got that as a prize at work like 6 or 7 years ago. I never would have bought that on my own because that's like a $200 setup right there. It's the giant stock pot and then it's got a giant colander that goes in it and it has a steam basket and a lid. I never would have bought that. That's expensive. This guy here, its little brother, that happens to be an Narita brand as well. Hey, if I ever get big enough, Narita, we can talk about sponsorship, but it's not sponsored today. This guy was like $13. Great buy. Not that the Cuisinart isn't wonderful. I love it. If I'm doing ramen or pho for friends, I need that guy because that's the only way I can make enough broth for everybody. But if it's just for me and my house or maybe one or two people, this one. Super great. I can't keep saying I'm new at this, so I don't have an outro, but I still don't have an outro. But I've really enjoyed talking about things that steam today, and I hope you come back for our next video. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and tell me about the things that steam in your kitchen and what other cooking gadgets you might like to hear about in this series.